Welcome to the Teledynamics Video Training Series for the UCM 6300. Here are the topics being covered today. For simplicity, we have added a table of contents in the description below, allowing you to jump to a particular content section of the video. Now, let's get started. First, connect an Ethernet cable to the UCM. To power the unit, you can either use the power supply provided or use power over Ethernet to the LAN port, as shown here. Once connected to the network, the unit obtains an IP address automatically through DHCP, which is different from previous UCM versions. If you are unsure of what IP address the UCM has obtained, please look at the LCD display on the top of the unit. Pressing the checkmark button will show you the IP address, as in the picture here. If you find DHCP is not being provided on your network, you can change to using a static IP, which we will not cover at this time. Once you've discovered the IP address of the UCM, the next step is to open a web browser and connect to the graphical user interface, or GUI, of the UCM. Normally, you can just type in the IP address of the UCM into the browser's address bar, but if this does not work in your case, you can just type in the full HTTPS address. I've provided an example in the text arrow above. You should also notice that the port for the browser to use has been added to the end of the IP address by using :8089. This is the default HTTPS port used for the UCM. After the IP address is entered, the login page will appear. The default username is admin, and the default password is on a sticker on the bottom of the unit. You will want to record this password and keep it in a safe place, since it is the password that will be used if the unit is ever factory reset. In the example shown, the incorrect password was entered to illustrate what happens after the first failed attempt to log in. The verification code, along with the correct password, must now be entered. You can click the verification code for a new one if you are unable to read the one currently being displayed. You are now logged into the GUI of the UCM. All UCM programming is done through this web GUI interface. Shown here is the dashboard, where you can easily see what interfaces are connected to the UCM, monitor CPU and memory usage, trunk status, etc. If you enjoyed this video, please click the like and subscribe buttons below. The voiceover service featured in this video has been provided by me, Allison Smith, of the IVR Voice. Contact me today for your customized IVR and voice services needs. If you have questions or need additional information about the topics covered in today's video, please contact your Teledynamics salesperson or contact us using the information provided here.